Hello there and welcome back to Strategic Command World War II War in Europe as we continue our campaign against the Wargaming Guy in 1944 D-Day scenario. It's a PBEM game against him. Go and check his previous video if you want to. I will add link to his channel and to his video in the description box below, so if you want, you go and check it. And last time I have ended recording video before I clicked the end turn button, so just to inform you, I've received 960 MPPs and no other thing happened except attrition losses to my two units east of Minsk. So let's see what will happen this time around. The summer has begun, we're in the middle of it. Narva will be taken. And Tallinn is under siege. What's remaining of Group Army Center? Ostrów has been taken. Now Dovgapilis will be under direct attack. He's moving very far. Without supply, that is. And those two guys lost some some strength due to attrition, and they were without supply, so they pretty much were easy pickings. And let's hope that he will finish off Minsk, because I will be able then to buy this unit back cheaply. Minsk holds out. Hold on, my friends, as long as you can, to the last bullet, of course. They've suffered some damage. Okay, I'm going after this guy. Easy. My HQ was destroyed, unfortunately. And he won't have much supply in here, I'm afraid. For him, of course, I'm afraid. The Dovgapilis is being encircled slowly. And what kind of supply does he have in here? I doubt he's got any. He's moving towards the Brechen as well. We might need to evacuate Kovel at some point. Okay, that's not the best option he had. And we've got my tanks ready to bounce this forward penetration of my lines. This artillery will begin pounding my forces. That's acceptable at this stage. I think I'm going to retreat him toward Krakow, and as we will abandon Lviv area quite soon. This guy was a sacrifice necessary. Hold on. Good job behind the river. Yes, amazing. You're not, but you held out. That's amazing. I will probably operate him away because we will need more troops in Poland itself. Beautiful defense. Now let's see what he will do in Italy. And ooh, beautiful! Easy clap, easy clap. My trap worked. Unfortunately, those tanks will be destroyed completely, and this HQ is in grave danger now, as my Luftwaffe is not up to the task yet. I'm not sure if he's got HQ, British HQ to support them. But those tanks, unfortunately, will be lost. Although they've held out bravely. That's a huge loss. Tanks have been landed. So many tanks. So many tanks, indeed. Dog of Pilis is under siege. Yes, lessons to his troops in France. If you haven't seen, last turn I have destroyed Polish corps in port. So that was great. That was beautiful. Sheffield Lake Reserve sank in the north. That was great. And a lot of convoy lines were raided. Army spotted near Ostrów. Okay, so let's start with naval assets as usually. I want to move my units to Canary Island as we've got this port in our control still, so we can resupply there. So let's follow this route. Oh no, I found him! Ranger carrier. That is very, very unfortunate. Now, Tirpitz did his job very, very well. But now he's in danger, so we need to evacuate him back to Narvik. Let's move the remaining of my units. Back to supply. If I had one more unit, we've cut off the railway in here, which means that Murmansk has only 5 supply at max. So if we can place another unit in here, we would be able to take Murmansk. Problem is that the only unit that we have available. It's probably some of these cores, and it's muddy, so we can't really operate them away the way I would love to. Now set his mode to okay. That will do. That will also have to do. And we've got my fighter slowly creeping into Norway. So next turn, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, we'll be able to transport my core in defense. Here. Only 2 supply, only 3 supply, still that's a lot, considering. And he moved this guy next to my tank, my anti-tank unit, so that's great. But let's start in Italy, where he didn't do anything last turn, so let's upgrade my tanks. A lot of entrenchment. I want to advance. Put more pressure to him. He's got a full control of d6. So, who to advance? You definitely. And I want this artillery in here. Let's try to weaken him a little bit. That's okay, and next time we will have tanks available. That's nice. Now let's see. Ah, it's raining in the channel, but not on the isles itself. That's bad. Their supply sucks, as you can see. So we will be able to break some of these guys. Sure. Now those tanks are just annoying as heck. Let's hit Cherbourg, then we'll hit port. We might bomb them if necessary. Have range to bomb. Not everything that I would love to bomb. So let's move my air power. Next to Tours. Oh, you're not grounded. So let's remedy that. We'll have to destroy them. I would love so badly to upgrade those guys, but if what? Now let's take a look. What we have here, a Rommel attaching to those guys and these tanks. Oh, I don't want it to be attached. Then, fortunately, I've moved my forces a bit too quickly. Let's start with you. One definitely. One zero, of course. Yes. Now let's move in with my superior tanks. Crush them. Now we've got some units remaining still. These tanks we will have to move forward. Destroy the last pocket of his resistance. Now he's got only one supply in the city because he's got range in here. What I want to do is move him here. Oh, that's amazing. Eight core Saint Malo. Okay, let's move him here. Now, although he's not upgraded, we need him immediately to secure this very unfortunate sector.
Don't take too much damage.
That's a lot. Can we somehow... He's entrenched four though. It's not exactly amazing. We have to take some risks. Risks, there is just no other way. So, six core will land at half strength. Let's move him to Lorien to cover it. If we can break through him, then let's at least reinforce those guys. To move him forward. Five, only five, so we need to go here. I think that's acceptable. Well, let's move you to this position or here, because I want him to be able to move to those guys. As we will try to secure Brest first, and then whether my units will be destroyed or not, we'll see what we'll be able to do in Normandy itself. We're starting to bomb Cherbourg and Ord itself. They've got still great supply because they've got 5 supply from port and 5 supply from city. So we've taken 2 points. Next time we take another 2 points and we will switch between those positions. And we will hope for the best. That's pretty much it. And we've got tank to buy back as well. So that's it for the west at the moment. Now let's move here and see what we have to do. We've got 5 supply. Oh, he moved his HQ forward. And he's got good supply in here. Because it's still Soviet Union. So let's see what we can do around here. I think we will be able to do something. Oh, that seems pretty juicy to me. Tanks? For free? That would be amazing. If you can pull it off. 2-1. I can't operate you. Ah, Kishinev and Chassis are all in too weak of a supply situation. Because they have units adjacent to them, so we will have to fix it somehow. Are pretty well dug in into Kishinev. We can operate him. Also by foot, but we will need him to attack. So now, yeah, I will have to move him away from Yassi. Move those guys to Yassi, attack this tank and destroy it. Move to Kishinev, remain where you are, as I need to upgrade you. They do not have unit available next to, adjacent next to this Hungarian army, so I will upgrade it as I can now. We are pretty low when it comes to the strength, so I might need to move this Hungarian army and swap it. Reinforce him at the same turn. That's pretty good. I'd say pretty good. Now, can we break in? Not really. Not at this turn at least. Let's try to take care of them. If he wants to come in, let him come in. Now, got one shell. Those guys will... I want to destroy some of these forward units. So probably it will be... It is a time to abandon Lvov. Okay, we will not touch you. Definitely. This guy will be in our reserve, just in case. This army isn't going nowhere. Our troops will defend these positions quite easily. So let's use one of my shells. Those guys will definitely abandon those positions. We can't operate them, so let's just move them back toward Krakow and Gorlice. We will need someone in Gorlice as well. This army looks like can take some of the damage, so let's definitely help them with that. Let's retreat you just a little bit. We are beginning pretty well. And let's see if we can deal with these guys. We could destroy this guard army, but we can actually move him here. And that will be an easy kill if I ever saw one. Okay. So you can abandon this sinking ship. You can still retreat a little bit. And we need someone to dig in this hex. And this hex, okay. So this is our last line of defense. We can try to escape view. Or I can't even reinforce him because we've got only 6 supply left. So let's try to at least do it. Now what I'm afraid of is that those guys will just move, just pretty much run around to Białystok, and I do not want that to happen. So, resupply, he must be, have like, I don't even know how much supply. And what I know is that this core needs upgrades. And definitely Vilno also needs upgrades. Now let's see our range. We can attach Vilno. That will be fine. Now we have to decide whether to abandon Daugavpilis or not. And I think not, because they do not have supply sources. As Riga and Daugavpilis are not taken yet, so he will be forced to remain where he is. Only he's got supply only from Minsk. That's something to consider as well. But not... You are in danger of being encircled, and I've lost too many units to encirclement already. He's not in a great shape either. So we've stopped them in front of Baranovice long enough, I believe. So let's operate them away. Where will they come in first? We need another unit in here to dig in. So we'll move these guys, yeah. So the question is whether we land here or somewhere around this line. And two of these guys dig in on hexes that we can't operate into directly. And I think I am willing to give up Bialystok for now, as he won't get too big of supply until he takes Vilno and Grodno, so now the question is whether we move to Johannesburg or somewhere else. I think it's fine for now. Need to upgrade all of these guys, all of these positions. Reinforce who we have to reinforce. Upgrade you, definitely. You don't really need upgrades yet. You might need anti-tank upgrade, anti-aircraft upgrade, so that's something to consider. We've got two HQs in this section, but one of them was destroyed, unfortunately, so we will need another HQ. Now, we've pretty much done everything that we can this time. Siedlce will dig in. So, first things first, of course, I would have forgotten about you, you need upgrade immediately. I'm so worried about this. We need more time, unfortunately. And if they had gone into Fruriga, I would have secured him earlier, but I can't really afford to do that. One supply, let's hit him. Let's hit him, because that's a good trade, and there is not a single good trade around here, so let's not worry about that, and Dabgavpilis will hold them for at least a turn. So now we can buy some units back. Got two armies to buy back, which is huge. Two cores that we can buy back because we are under our limit. Bosch, HQ. Now, I know that we have tanks. So that's my priority. And one army we have to do. Two cores or one army. Not here. We need some sturdier units, I think. We can buy core, but without upgrades. So later on we would have to buy upgrades for much more money. As you can see, upgrades right now cost us only what? 72? 99? 25. If we would like to buy fresh unit with upgrades, they would cost us a lot more. 120, 45, huge difference, so I'm not sure it's wise, so I won't do it. Let's take a look at our production. An army in October, that's a long time from now, and a lot of tanks and one anti-tank unit. It will have to do. So we've got 72 MPPs left. So let's actually upgrade some of those guys that still need some love. And I'm wondering whether I should upgrade Khan. I can't because the city is completely obliterated. So I won't. That's pretty much settles it. Now, we've got one strike left and you haven't moved, so let's reinforce you. And you are my backup unit. And let's hope he won't be able to bombard me to pieces. Hopefully, now let's be honest, until September we won't be lucky enough to ground his air power, so not the best options that we have available right now, but Luftwaffe is not in a position to fight currently. Oh, I would have forgotten to move you. Let's move you here. Got how many units? 4 HQs for 28. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14, more than 21. Okay. So we need all these HQs there. So model will move closer to the center. We'll need someone to cover Presov as well. At least at some point. And we'll see what will happen next. I want to remain in Tallinn for now. Because he might not have enough units. Actually take it immediately, and we are entrenched at 3, so that's something. So I might actually buy one garrison to guarantee that we have some places covered, like here. I don't want them to just jump into Oradea and take it easily, but though this is a lot of MPPs that we might need. Buy back some more precious units, let's call it that way. So I will have to wonder. You know what? Not right now. We can't afford it at this stage. Now the other question is, do we abandon Lviv? Or do we allow them to encircle it with my army? I probably made a bit of a mistake by not moving this artillery unit further and attacking. But he's got some targets to take care of immediately. And our line in front of Vistula River is looking pretty... We're starting to do something around it, which is great. Because we've lost like 5 units due to my mistake by placing HQ in this hex instead of this hex, and in the very first turn, and I weren't able to operate all these units on the railway around between Orsha and Minsk, which was a huge blunder on my side, but it's too late to fix it now. And that will be it for this turn, I believe. As we continue our fight to the last bullet against the Wargaming Guy in 1944 D-Day scenario, as we celebrate D-Day anniversary, 76th anniversary this way. So first of all, allow me to save my game to see if everything is in order. Loading, okay, so we shall be fine. All right. All right. So now let's end turn. I will not forget it. I will not forget to record it from now on. So let's do it and see what awaits us. Actually, maybe let's take a look at the reports. A lot of units that we are facing. Not very surprising, national morale. It's quite good. Losses? We are actually... Of course, we are losing more than we can actually suffer, but... We are losing less as the time goes. Let's take a look at Soviet losses. Not really huge. American losses a lot this turn, and British losses a lot of this turn as well. And British can't actually cover these losses with the income they have. Americans, of course, can. Let's take a look at their investments. Nothing really. He's invested into something as Americans, but no diplomatic actions, and as Soviet Union as well, but he did not invest into diplomacy, which is great. And he's losing a bit of money as we raid his convoy routes, but not really that much. Everything is covered. Once more, let's take a look. Okay, we've got this guy ready to pounce next turn, as we will counter attack in Italy. Maybe at least we'll try to divert some of his forces. That's the idea. So that will be it, as this is one of those long goodbyes of mine. So let's finish the turn without further ado and see what decision events will pop up or other circumstances. Nothing. So we've received 986 MPPs, but we've still got this decision event impounding on my economy, which is above 1000 MPPs per turn, which is still very good for us. Well, it's looking all right so far, I'd say, this war, but well, it will take one turn and we will swing, we'll be swung into the point of no recovery options. So let's try to preserve my strength for as long as I can. So thank you for watching. Go and check the Wargaming Guy's turn if you want. And I will see you next time.